My name is Kevin Donohue. I'm the Databeam Professor of Electrical and Computer Engineering. The signal and application area is focused on developing systems that are designed to reliably extract information from processes and other systems of interest. You know, an example of that is people who are listening and watching this video right now are taking in changes in the sound, changes in the light on their computer screen. And from that, their sensors, their eyes and their ears are sending signals to the brain, and the brain's converting those to get meaning. As electrical engineers, we're not necessarily limited to sight and sound that humans can perceive directly. We use other forms of energy to give us information like ultrasound, x-rays, electromagnetics. The main focus, though, for the last 6 years here in the Visualization Center has been distributed audio systems. And that we're mainly concerned is how do we arrange systems of microphones to be able to identify sounds in the room and track them. In particular, voices would be that of interest. And that has applications in things like surveillance and smart rooms. So if you can imagine a research lab like this, we'll sometimes be looking at trying to solve a problem, we'll have brainstorming sessions. And we'll start a discussion, and the discussion may devolve into several sub-conversations that go on at once. And we do try to take notes at those meetings, but it's very difficult. If we had a system like what we have with this distributed audio system, that we'd be able to locate each of the sounds, each of the voices, be able to separate them, it could archive all those conversations in a way that we can go back to it in an efficient way, because it's labeled and we could go into some kind of a database that we can search efficiently and quickly. And then for surveillance, if you can imagine you have a person of interest and he's in a crowded room or a restaurant where there's lots of voices, and obviously if they're saying something that doesn't want to be heard, they're talking in soft voices. So with law enforcement, if they had the opportunity, they can put microphones around the room if they knew beforehand. The stuff that we do would be focused on how do we process the signals from all those microphones to ultimately extract this weak voice from this sea of loud voices, which we sometimes call that the cocktail party problem. We've also made some advances in what we call masking in that cocktail party problem to get that soft voice out of a multitude of voices. What our auditory cortex does, it has an ability when we decide to focus on someone, is that we start to track into their signal, and our neurons actually will synchronize to the signal of the person of interest, and then other neurons will actually suppress the background noises. And even though we don't have that cognitive ability in our computer system, we have many ears, whereas the human only has two ears. So we've exploited that to come out with a new way of masking and bring out some very hard to detect voices and make them intelligible. So in the future, we really want to be able to improve this idea of smart rooms, make them smarter, give them more capabilities. We have to make things more robust. I mean, we can get the problems to work for small situations, but to get them to be cheap enough, run fast enough, that's really our goal.